On Monday evening at dusk, the Israel conference team got on the bus one by one. We focused our hearts on God in prayer. We arrived at Incheon International Airport. Prayer for going to the end of the earth was so sincere. Our church members are praying with all their hearts, knowing that they will be convinced that Jesus is the true Messiah and Savior, and that our Lord will do His work. In answer to their prayer, I surely believe that my God will achieve a great thing which is unprecedented among the people of Israel and Palestine. We are leaving with a sense of mission that we should deliver the will of God and the glory of God, the gospel of the blood of Jesus, and that we should fulfill His will to save people. An aeroplane taking Jesus' troops who will carry out Jesus' command arrived at Amman Airport from Incheon via Dubai. After arriving in Amman, they entered Bethlehem by land, crossing the border between Jordan and Israel at the Allenby Bridge. Jerusalem, the land of the Bible, where we could almost feel the breath of Jesus. Jerusalem is the capital city of Israel. The majority of Israel, 6.9 million people, are deeply religious. Of the Israeli population, about 80% are Jews and 20% Muslim. The Israeli-Palestinian conflict over religion and territory is the ongoing struggle between Israelis and Palestinians. Bullet marks can clearly be seen everywhere and obvious proof of the severity of the conflict. Armed troops are deployed to prevent terror attacks as tension is high. This is the ceremonial hall where the conference will be held in Bethlehem. Staff who passionately wanted to save even one soul showed perfection in taking care of everything. Audio engineers wanted to achieve the best sound. There was a lot of tension due to the heavy weight of responsibility. The organizers who are doing their ministry in Bethlehem particularly had great anticipation of miracles.
It's an honor to really have Pastor Yoon and Yonsei Baptist Church come to Bethlehem, because we are sensing this year, it's a year of prayer, a year of revival, and to us to learn from the Korean people how to pray, and for the Koreans to learn from the Arab people and the Christian Arab people, the Palestinian Christians, how they live. I think it's going to build the kingdom and the future of the Middle East. Thank you, Yonsei Baptist Church, for coming to Israel and Palestinian territories. God bless you.
In the evening, people started to gather, and the Lord's troops from Korea arrived. The people who were crowded in wondered, who is Jesus to them? Pastor Yun's sermon was interpreted twice, first into English, then into Arabic. It is not easy to interpret, but it is certain that the Holy Spirit works in the hearts of those who heard. If you owed $1 million, you'd be free from the debt when you paid off all the money. Likewise, Jesus came to the earth to pay for the wages of sin by dying on the cross, taking up our transgressions by which we should go to hell. He paid the wages of sin for those who believe this. Therefore, you have no sins and you must go to heaven. Pastor Yoon was very tired because of the long journey from Korea to Israel, but he didn't care about his fatigue. He just preached with a passion for saving souls. The people of Bethlehem, where Jesus was born, think that Jesus is one of the prophets. How did they accept the gospel? In Korea, we pray with our hands raised.
Please raise up both of your hands.
We found that they prayed and their souls were touched. They met God deeply while they were praying. However, sadly, there were some people who didn't accept the gospel, but just watched those who were praying. But our team members tried to intercede for them. Eventually, the sermon delivered by a pastor from a foreign country started to change their minds, and they began to express that they'd received the grace of God.
Very nice. I feel very, very, very good today, yes.
It's very happy to coming to here. It's very nice. Welcome to the Korean here. I am happy, like Jesus, he want to do something here. And God bless this group and the pastor. And
I pray for him. I pray, and I want from him to help me and help my family and my children, and take the peace in the world. We need the peace in the Holy Land and all the world. Thank you. God bless you and your pastor and your heart and your life, everything. Thanks for you thanks the Lord.
The next morning, the group from Korea wanted to feel the same grace they'd received the previous day in the field, so they went on a pilgrimage. Jerusalem is a biblical location, so we walked a road where Jesus might have walked. The places we saw with our eyes, the paths we trod with our feet, and the rocks we touched with our hand, Jesus might also have touched. We visited the holy places of the Bible, including the Chapel of Ascension. This is the Via Dolorosa, the path of the cross, the way of suffering, where Jesus was led in agony carrying the cross. It is 400 meters long from Antonia Fortress to Golgotha. There are many stores lining the street. The pilgrims carrying the cross kept walking along the path, meditating on the depth of Jesus' suffering. I often forget the meaning of the cross. When I walked along the path where Jesus walked in agony, I asked myself if I have been walking the way of the cross without denying it and taking up my own cross as a pastor. Thinking about the cross, I felt shame and was so sorry for what I've done. These days, the Via Dolorosa is turned into a marketplace. This is the fifth station where Simon assisted Jesus to carry the cross. We saw the sixth station where a woman wiped Jesus' face with a small cloth. The place where Jesus suffered for me, for my salvation. The saints who walked the path and breathed in the air were just weeping without speaking when they were faced with the place of suffering. But the Christians who live in the land where Jesus shed his sacred blood are still being persecuted.
Years ago, I was coming, parking my car down, open garage. I didn't see somebody was hiding behind the wall.
그때 제가 그 저쪽에 사람이 숨어 있는 걸 못 봤습니다.
The moment I stepped out of the car,
근데 제가 차에서 나오자마자,
he shot me four bullets.
저한테 총을 네 방을 쐈습니다.
One hit my left shoulder.
하나는 여기 맞았고,
and they thought I was dead. I'm gone.
그리고서는 제가 쓰러져 갖고 움직이지 못하니까 죽었는지 알고 사람들이 이제 죽었구나 하고 떠났습니다.
This is the door of the church run by Pastor Corey in Bethlehem. The bullet holes stand for the marks of terror attacks. It was horrible when I came home. While I was dumping trash into the trash can, the gift exploded.
Here, the bomb, the package was here and it blew. Because now, as you know, if somebody gets on the computer, they can see where I am. There's a program on the computer, they can see where I'm at. With me, what they'll probably do is put a bomb underneath my car. So I have to check the car every day underneath. Or by my telephone, they can see when I'm out of Ariel, they'll follow me and shoot me.
place was overrun. We never did have the service. They overturned chairs. People were climbing up over the fence. It was really unpleasant.
The land where tribe fights against tribe and nation against nation. This land remembers the Holocaust during World War II. Germans made Christianity the official state religion.
Who killed millions of Jews are still bothering us in Israel. They hunt us in Europe, in America. They are anti-Semitic. They are killing Jews all over the history. And they come here to Israel, to our country. Our only one country we have. And they come and bothering us, hunting us. So we are here to protest.
It's the old mistake, 100%. And they believe the old mistake. All the other beliefs for me, they're not true. So and the other one, the new, it's not true. I don't know who write it or was the people that write it.
If you ask me, I'll say he's wrong. But if you ask him, it's Judaism wrong, he'll say he's wrong. So how do I think about it? I think they're wrong. I think they have the wrong religion.
One of the basic beliefs in Judaism is that there's only God. We don't make people...
Jews do not accept Christianity because of the historical background. They are still waiting for their own Messiah and living according to the law. Among the Jews, there are Christians who are called Messianic Jews, who make up 1% of the population and are being persecuted by Jewish law that doesn't acknowledge converts to Christianity. Nevertheless, they have kept their faith and sincerely long for salvation by the blood of Jesus.
So I do believe that we are in the end times. I do believe that the return of Christ is near. I really believe so.
This is the hour. This is the time. The Christian community really have to understand at this hour of history their obligation to Israel in bringing the gospel to them.
Because we are waiting for the Spirit to come upon Israel. The restoration of Israel in this land is prophetic, is according to the timetable of the Lord.
So the more Jews that come to know Yeshua, the more people from the nations come to know Yeshua.
Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. It's actually praying that, Lord, come quick, save the people of Israel. When there will be peace here, there will be peace also in Seoul. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem.
Israel, where the earnest hope and desire turned into prayer and the seed of prayer was planted. The place of the miracle in Bethlehem where Jesus revealed himself as our Savior. This is the Palestinian area. There are about 180,000 people living here, but Christians take up less than 1%. They consider it a big conference, even when 200 or 300 people gather, but this time there will be 1,000. You don't know what brings a series of misfortune upon you, but God knows that it's the devil's work. The voice that filled the conference hall. The voice of believers that resounded at the end of the earth. Salvation, which has returned to this place after 2,000 years of turning around the earth, filled this place with miracles and wonders. Please raise your hand if you want to believe in Jesus, be happy, and if you want to go to heaven. Miracles happened. Those who accepted Jesus raised their hands toward the Lord. Among 1,000 people who attended, about half of them decided to believe in Jesus. With shouts of joy, they started to give testimony about the kinds of diseases from which they were cured and all their troubles being taken away. I couldn't walk well yesterday because I was sick, but now I am walking, as you can see. When I listened to the sermon, the Holy Spirit touched my heart. I'm totally cured. I fell from the top of a long ladder while picking olives. I hurt my head and had a fracture on my hip bone. God healed the pain, so now I'm all right and I feel good.
We will be in heaven and we're going to be meeting together and eating with the Lord Jesus at his supper. And you would be surprised how many people were blessed by your message and how many people were saved and rejoiced and their life and happiness were restored by your lovely preaching and by your powerful sincerity and loving heart you have for souls and lost souls. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, in my food and dear in my God. But now it's better, thanks to God. God.
I feel a nice feeling in myself. I feel something, some change inside.
Excellent. I felt the power of the Holy Spirit upon Pastor Yoon and upon all of us. And the world was really anointed by the Holy Spirit. And that's beautiful. And you see the touch of the Holy Spirit in so many lives, so many people getting saved, so many people get healed. And that's what it's all about.
The three-day conference culminated in success. However, the chosen army of faith to preach the gospel of God will keep on marching to restore this land. Even if there is only one person who doesn't believe in Jesus, Pastor Yoon and Yonsei Central Baptist Church will go on to save that person.